Into it, mailing a car.
Oh, wow.
And I did go to the funeral.
Now you should hear me better, right? Good morning. Welcome to worship. Welcome to those who are gathered online. Anna is going to light the candles, but I'll invite all of us to stand as we sing our beginning song, Everlasting God. The words are in the back of your bulletins.
Thank you.
Indeed, we gather with our everlasting God for worship this morning. I invite you to share your name with someone else, maybe someone that you haven't seen for a long time, maybe even cross the aisles to someone new. And if you aren't sure what to talk about, maybe this is All Saints Day when the church remembers those who passed away. So maybe you'll share someone that you're missing today yourself. Let us say hello to each other. I invite you to stand as you are able. It is traditional to share the names of our loved ones who have died, and so during this time of prayer we will remember these are folks that people who've given names to me for us to include. I'll also leave space at the end, so if there's a name that you want to share, you'll be able to do that as well. After each name, we will hear the toll of the bell. Let us pray. O God of the Pilgrim's Way, we give thanks for those in generations past who have been examples for us of God's love at work in the world. As we pray, we know that we are surrounded by this great rejoicing cloud of witnesses. Yet even as we name these holy ancestors, we thank God for others whose names we never knew or have forgotten, who showed us the meaning of life in Christ. We give thanks for the life of Hart Legner, Vi Curtin, Richard Betcher, William Schiavone, Tim Edie, Henrietta Edie, Raymond Edie, Bob, Stella, and John Shaner, Steve Downer, Carolyn Balwit Gray, Francis Balwit, John Balwit, Kevin Edwards, Betty and David Kress Sr., Eileen Toomey London, Lola Kettner Caldwell, Louise Robinson, Veronica Marjama, Donald Hookey, Barbara Joy, Sean David Doyle, Chuck Klimak, Stella Congas, Donna Soderstrom, Ken Bates, Marlos Bates, Peggy Ostley, David Felt, Ross Brennan, Dan August, and those we name aloud at this time. Eloise left. Holy God, we honor these, our ancestors in faith and members of our family. We too seek to do your will. We too desire to be your servants. We too long to know you clearly and in time bring us to our eternal home of peace and joy. You may be seated. A reading comes from the very last book in the Bible, reading from the book of Revelation. It was written by John of Patmos, who has this apocalyptic vision of the end times. And this is one of the more beautiful passages in the book of Revelation as it talks about the coming of a new heaven and a new earth. Let us hear from Revelation. I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end." I'll invite the children to come forward. Good morning. So I have a box with me again. Yay! And so I would invite someone to take the lid off and see what's in this box. Go ahead. And there's several things in the box this time. Can you pull out the top thing? And what is that? It's a picture. And what's a picture of? A guy called Hart Legner. I'm going to hold this up so other people can see. Some of you may know Hart Legner, and some of you probably don't. You know, on this day every year, the church remembers those who have died. And one of those that died this past year was Hart Legner. But some of you, as I said, don't know him. So let us remember him, and let me tell you a little bit about him. Hart loved kids. And he taught Sunday school. He taught the 5th and 6th Sunday school class. Any of you in 5th or 6th grade right now? Just one, right? So Hart Legner was a great teacher. What I'm going to invite you to do is place this frame on the little table in front of the altar. Because one of the things we remember on All Saints Day is that when we receive communion around the altar table, we also commune with those who have passed on ahead of us. So could you put that on the table? I have another picture. These are four people that have died that we've had their funeral services at Faith in the past year. So who would like to hold this other picture? Ryan. Very good. And this is a picture of Vi Curtin. Can you hold that up so people can see? Yeah. Now, so Vi Curtin was a lovely lady. She loved to invite people into their house and have tea and cookies. Anybody like cookies when you go visit people? You would love to visit her. And she also was in the Bible class. So some folks know her from church from being in Bible class as well. So we give thanks for her life today. Ryan, can you put that on the other table? There you are. I have another one. Who would like to hold this up? Aurora, you want to hold this up? This is a man by the name of Richard Betcher. And he was a police officer. He was a police officer in North Andover. And one of the things that he did is he made sure that when you call 911, that emergency number, that local folks would come and answer that call. So that was pretty special, what he did there. Aurora, could you put that next on that table again? And I have one more. Who would like to hold this up? There you are. You have a picture of Tim Eady. Now, for those of you who don't know Tim Eady, if you look at these screens and you look at those video cameras up there, Tim helped make sure that we could videotape worship services so that those people who couldn't come to church would be able to watch the worship service from home. Can you put that up on that tape? There. There we go. That's okay. Very good. Yeah. So, you know, this is sometimes a sad day because we remember people who have passed away. But it's also a day when we give thanks that God has promised that every time we come to the communion table, we commune with everyone who has been before us. And so that's a special day to remember them. So let's fold our hands, say a prayer. Dear God, we thank you for those who have passed on ahead of us, who have been examples of faith. We pray this in your name, a name of thanks. Amen. Thank you. You guys can go to Sunday school. Our gospel reading today comes from the Gospel of John. When Mary came where Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who came with her also weeping, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. He said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus began to weep. So the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?" Then Jesus again, greatly disturbed, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone was lying against it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the sister of the dead man, said to him, "Lord, already there is a stench, because he has been dead 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. And Jesus looked upward and said, "Father, I thank you for having heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I have said this for the sake of the crowd standing here, so that they may believe that you sent me." When he had said this, he cried out with a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, his hands and feet bound with strips of cloth, and his face wrapped in a cloth. Jesus said to them, "Unbind him and let him go." I'm going to begin my message this morning by saying, don't try this at home. It could be dangerous, what I'm about to share with you, so don't try it at home. But let me tell you the truth. Sometimes I like to eat raw cookie dough. especially chocolate chip cookie dough. Now, maybe you can imagine this the next time that you're making chocolate chip cookies. There's a cookie sheet in front of you, and you're putting one rounded tablespoon after another, perfectly spaced on the tray, and then you're left with a little bit that just isn't going to make a real size cookie, right? And so I tend to eat the raw cookie dough. I scrape it out. Don't try this at home. But here's the thing. As I put that tray in the oven, as I begin to smell the cookies baking, there's nothing better than baked cookies, right? The cookie dough is only a foretaste of the feast to come. That's a theological concept that we talk a lot about at church, that here when we gather at communion, here in this life, it's but a foretaste of the feast to come. You know, I can enjoy cookie dough. If I had never tasted cookies, I think I would be pretty satisfied with just the cookie dough. And yet, now I know it is but a foretaste of the feast to come. All Saints' Day, the church remembers those who have gone on ahead of us. We are reminded that life is good, and yet it's but a foretaste of the feast to come. Some of you are probably familiar with the Life is Good brand of t-shirts, right? There's two brothers, Ben and John Jacobs, who formed the company. It's a Boston-based company. Maybe you knew that. And it started in 1990. The brothers used to joke among themselves that we will go where no t-shirt guys have gone before. So they created this design and t-shirt, which emphasizes the simple joys in life. Life is good. Walking on the beach, tossing a ball, eating cookie dough. They don't have the cookie dough t-shirt yet, I don't think. I'm guessing it may be some legal reasons. Life is good. There are simple joys in life that we can appreciate, but it's only a foretaste of the feast to come. You know, sometimes I hear people who know that promise, that our life here is but a foretaste of the feast to come. And sometimes when someone they have loved dies, there's a sense that for some reason, if they are truly faithful, that they should not display their grief. If I had a nickel for every person who apologized to me for crying at the time of a loss, I would be a wealthy woman. Our culture somehow gives the idea that tears are inappropriate in public. Well, if you get embarrassed by crying in public, this gospel is for you. Because you see, Mary cries, her friends all cry, and Jesus has an ugly cry. If you're familiar with the story, some of the background is that Jesus is good friends with these two sisters, Mary and Martha, and their brother Lazarus. They live in this town called Bethany, not far from Jerusalem, so some people think that Jesus would probably go there when he was in Jerusalem, and that's how he got to know them. Well, at this point in the story that we've heard is Lazarus has died, and Mary is distraught. And she goes running out to Jesus when she sees him coming, and it's taken him a few days to get there. She goes out to him, she falls at his knees, and she says, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. And then we hear that Jesus is moved. He's greatly disturbed. The word in Greek actually means the movement of the arteries in your stomach, splenizomai. He's viscerally moved. And he begins to weep. Isn't that wonderful? That we have an example of a God who weeps with us. It's interesting, isn't it? We know a lot about how we cry as human beings. We know about the lacrimal glands and the ducts and how they get overfilled and they fall out onto our faces. We know a lot about how we cry. We don't know as much about why we cry, especially in times of great emotion. Why is it that we can cry at a beautiful piece of music? Why is it that we can cry when our home team throws a touchdown? Why is it that we can cry when a little one says their first words? Why is it that when I look at my mother's closet and I see her bathrobe still hanging there, it makes me cry? We know a lot how we cry, but not really why we cry. And I'll invite you to consider that we should not dismiss those tears. Something holy happens when we cry. Something that draws us close to God. Don't wipe them away too easily. We have a God who feels, who cries with us. Now, for a long time, that was a heresy. There's this group of New Testament Christians who thought they were called Marcionites, and they thought that God was immutable, did not show emotion, and that anyone believed that God could cry was a heretic. Thankfully, the church read scripture. The church read and understood that Jesus cried. He wept. Don't dismiss your tears. They are holy. I'd like to conclude just with a blessing, and it's from Kate Bowler. Some of you may know her. I think I've probably mentioned her before. She's a professor at Duke Divinity School. She's 35 years old and was diagnosed with stage 4 colon cancer. She writes a lot about grief, cancer, illness, and she has a 7-year-old son. She talks about how he might remember her. So hear this blessing for you. Blessed are you who feel the wound of fresh loss, or of the loss, no matter how fresh, that still makes your voice crack all these years later. You who are stuck in the impossibility, frozen in disbelief, how can this be? It wasn't supposed to be this way. Blessed are you, wounded, broken, changed. Blessed are you who keep parenting, who keep friendships and jobs afloat. Blessed are you who continue to move forward with a life you didn't choose, with a loss you thought you couldn't live without. One small step, one small act of hope at a time. Blessed are you. Amen. I invite you to stand as you're able, as together we sing Sweet Mercies. I invite you to join with me in our confession of faith. This confession for faith of faith today comes from the Indigenous people of New Zealand. We confess that we believe in and belong to the one true and living God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, love before all love. We believe in God the Father, sovereign and holy, creator and nurturer of all, Father of Jesus Christ, sender of the Holy Spirit, and judge of all the earth. We believe in God the Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, truly human and truly divine, who lived among us full of grace and truth. For our sin he was crucified, and by the power of God was raised from death, forgiving us, setting us free, and bringing to birth God's new creation. Now ascended, he calls us to repentance and faith, and restores us to God and to one another. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, the giver of life at work in all creation, who inspired the scriptures and makes Christ known, who transforms hearts and minds and gathers us into the community of Christ, empowering the church in worship and in mission. We belong to this triune God, women and men, young and old, from many nations. In Christ we are one people, witnesses to God's love in word and action, servants of reconciliation, and stewards of creation. As God's people, we look forward in hope and joy to the return of Christ, to the new heaven and earth, where evil and death will be no more, justice and peace will flourish, and we shall forever delight in the glory of God. Amen. At this time, we will receive our offerings. You may be seated. Is there someone who would be... Oh, our acolyte will collect our offering. As we receive our offerings, we will sing A Shield About Me.
Thank you.
I invite you to stand as you're able. Eternal God, you hold firm amid the changes of this world. Hear us now as we pray for the church, the world, and everyone in need. Creating God, we praise you for abundant harvests and the goodness of creation. Create communities of care for your earth so that all land, water, and soil will be celebrated and cherished by future generations of saints. Hear us, O God. God of peace, we give you thanks for nations of peace that serve as a refuge for all whose homelands are afflicted with violence. Strengthen those who continue to work for peace and support all veterans who carry the scars of war. Hear us, O God. God of healing, we give you thanks for healthcare workers who labor around the clock to answer cries for help. Bring wholeness to all who struggle with post-traumatic stress disorder, anxiety, depression, addiction, and all who long for healing in any way, especially Andrew, the Rohr family, Lynn and Carla Buffington, the family of Dan August, who died last week, Sarah Johnson, Tim Tinknell, Mackenzie Gagnon, Lori Gardner, Phil Leobo, James Leno, Melanie Armstrong, and Art Derbyshire. Hear us, O God. God of justice, we praise you for feeding ministries and for all meals that bring people together for nourishment and fellowship. Bless chefs, bakers, servers, dishwashers, communion assistants, and grocery deliverers. Hear us, O God. God of the ages, we give you thanks for the saints of this congregation who have inspired, challenged, loved, and taught us. Wipe away our tears and lead us by their example until we feast together on your holy mountain. Hear us, O God. This day we also pray for healing for Mary Johnson, who is recovering from surgery. And we pray for Sally Bates, the mother of Lori Gardner. We pray for those whose names we name aloud or silently in our hearts at this time. God, our protection and strength, we entrust to you all for whom we pray. Remain with us always, through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. When we offer God our confession, we join the beautiful work of reconciliation that begins with our reconciling with God. Trusting in our partner in grace, let us pray our confession. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, open our hearts so that we are able to admit to you the fullness of our lives, that which is beautiful and good, and that which is hurtful and hateful. We confess that we do not follow Jesus in all that we do. We love with condition. We judge and condemn. We cast the first stone and keep the logs in our own eyes. We do not turn to you as the source of our healing. Forgive us, we pray. Forgive our sin and empower us to be imitators of Christ in love and service. Amen. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come to the table. It is Christ who meets us here. All are welcome. For those who are worshiping at home, hear these words for yourselves. The body of Christ is given for you. The blood of Christ is shed for you. You may be seated. Is there somebody that would be able to help with communion today? Thank you, Lisa. When you come forward, you can either kneel or stand at the altar rail. We have X marks every other spot so that there is enough space between us. There, I will place a wafer. I will drop it into your hand, which you may consume, and then you can take a glass of wine from the tray and then consume that. There is grape juice as well as individually wrapped communion elements in the tray and forward, so if you would prefer that, you may take that on your way up around the table. Come to the table, you are invited. I invite you to stand as you're able. Let us pray. God of beginnings and endings, as we prepare to conclude this worship, we once again lift up our hearts to you, the divine source of all life. You have blessed our coming together. Now bless our departure and journeys homeward. Amen. The blessing of God who is in this place and every place, the blessing of Jesus, who is among us, often unrecognized. The blessing of the Holy Spirit, encouraging us to welcome and to feel at home, be with us all. Amen. Our sending song is Rock of Ages. Beginning after the service, after I greet all these lovely people, we will meet in the Sunday school classroom for First Communion class. Also, my installation is a week from today at 4 p.m. So I hope that you are able to come. It'll be indeed a time of celebration. I'm glad that the band will be part of it as well.
So be right here?
Right here in worship space. Yes, yes. And then also, 2 weeks from today, during coffee hour, so come a little bit early, we'll have a special coffee hour for Shauna Wagner, our church administrator, who now has a full-time job, but she's been wonderful for the last 9 years. And so come early, 2 weeks from today, for coffee hour, so that you can say thank you to her in person. Tom, did you have...
Next Saturday, we we really want to do something nice for you. And November 28th, you're going to have the all-church packaging event. We get together, and there's two lines, 12 people, a lot of lines. We need 24 people. We make beans and rice. There are packages of beans and rice, and we give them to Bread and Roses and Lazarus House. They figured it out, and it's like 30 cents per serving. And the last time we did this, I brought it over to the food pantry, and a couple months later, they found a note, like, written on an envelope with, like, pencil, saying the beans and rice were really good, I was really hungry, thank you, and do you have any more? And the food pantry posted it online, and the guy who organizes this for us, like said, isn't these from Faith Lutheran? So I just bring that up, that you, what you guys do really matters. And I hope you, like, maybe in the week get some spare change and put it in the nice thing. And then on the 28th, like, roll up your sleeves and help package some meals.
Go in peace, serve the Lord.